I'm on the boardwalk. The boardwalk, even. Here in Abbeyleix Bog. It's beautiful. Niamh here as your science communicator in residence for the climate action project of Abbeyleix. It's amazing the people that you can meet along the way. I see somebody up there, somebody who likes birds a lot. It's Ricky from BirdWatch Ireland. Ricky.
Hi.
You are involved in bird conservation.
Yes.
Can you tell us how the climate has affected birds?
Yeah, so birds are very good environmental indicators. So if we study birds over long periods, we can sort of tell what the environment's doing. And in terms of climate change, we have a couple of examples that people might be familiar with. Swallows, for example. Mm-hmm. We know since the 1960s are arriving about 2 weeks earlier each summer, and that's been brought on by climate change and warmer temperatures here, and they're also staying about 2 weeks longer, because the weather is sort of milder into the autumn. So over time since the 60s, so on average swallows are staying about an extra month, in that period. So it's quite interesting.
Interesting, isn't it?
That's one good example. Other examples are we have species that are doing this thing it's called short stopping. So species of duck and wildfowl that would have returned from the Arctic where they've bred in the winter, or sorry, in the summer,
yeah.
Would return to Ireland to overwinter here where it's milder. But now they don't need to come as far because it's much milder up north. So what you're seeing is this range shift where they're staying up in Scandinavia because there's no longer ice-covered lakes, so they can stay there. And we call that short stopping. So that's another effect of climate change.
It's amazing. What else, Ricky?
So other species as well are they synchronized their egg laying with the availability of prey species. So we know blue tits, for example, eat a lot of green caterpillars early in the spring.
Yeah.
So they need to synchronize the eggs hatching when the caterpillars are available. But because the spring, because the weather and the climate and the seasons are no longer in sync because of climate change, they've actually on occasion got that wrong and they've ended up not being able to raise as many chicks. So that's, they need to try to get that right. And so that's a problem for blue tits, for example. And one other effect, which is kind of a positive if you look at it, is we're getting species are now colonising Ireland that were never here before. So the little egret is a good example.
Uh-huh.
It's a white heron, and they first bred here in 97, and now they're very widespread species, and we expect other species to begin to colonise from Europe in the next few years.
So there are some things about climate change that help us see more interesting birds and birds that kind of hang around a little bit longer than they would have in the past.
Yeah, absolutely. There's all those examples, yeah.
That's great. Okay, thanks, Ricky. That's great. I'm really glad I bumped into Ricky in the middle of the bog. All right, thank you. Over and out.